This school has been on the grounds of a school for thousands of years. So there's thousands of years of mysteries that have taken place at the school and do take place. And it's a very mysterious place where the teachers and the headmaster don't seem to know that it's going on, but the kids do.
All these stuff that they took place in the school.
This machine must be some sort of remote crime scanner.
Automatic rubricator. It says so right on the panel. Somewhere up above, there must be sensors that have been in the school for centuries.
Yeah, and in fact, one of the reasons I wanted to do this was to be able to work in the UK, because I know a lot of British writers, they want to come to Los Angeles, but a lot of us American comedy writers, we hold British comedy to sort of be the height of comedy. I find the process here in the UK is a lot more conducive to being creative. And we got a lot more encouragement from the BBC than I ever had experienced in 20 years previously of any American network. I come from sort of an unusual background in the US because I started on The Simpsons. And when The Simpsons was created, it was when the Matt Groening, Jim Brooks, and Sam Simon, who created the show, brought it to the Fox Network. The Fox Network was in its very early stages, and the Fox Network agreed that they would not interfere at all with the creative process. So we were really allowed to do whatever we wanted, and we had complete freedom. But that's really unheard of in American TV, because there's a lot of interference from different levels, and also people are a lot more afraid of comedy and trying new things than I find they are here. You're hired on the staff of a show, which means you work there full time. And so, for example, on a show like The Simpsons or Futurama, unless you're outside the writer's room writing a script, you're in a writer's room. And that's where they bring everything from the genesis of a story, talking about what the story is going to be, mapping that out. And then once the script is written, then you bring it back to the writer's room. And of a group, you rewrite it and you find what's not working with the story, what jokes you can improve. But you always find that a group of writers together, you'll just generate much better ideas than you ever could on your own.
Poor Templeton. We've got to rescue him before that giant mysterious beast does any number of horrible unknown things to him. It's also mysterious. It's a bit thrilling. I wish I could enjoy it, but our friends in trouble, we must. Mitchell, where'd you go?
Over here. I came up with a plan 10 seconds ago.
I guess in the UK, you don't really have actual writers' rooms or full-time staffs. And I think that's the one thing that American comedy has over British comedy is that we have actual rooms of writers and full-time staff that get together. But just having us together, you come up with ideas and you spark each other and you encourage each other. And even if there's a bad idea, which I've also learned that you never say that's a bad idea, you never put down a bad idea because you never know what it could lead to. But it's just other writers working. Writing is such a solitary art, and it's rare to come together. But when you do, you just find there's an energy that feeds off each other. One rule that we had on The Simpsons and that we follow on Strange Hill High, and I think all great animated shows follows that even though these characters are cartoon characters, we treat them as real people. We write as if we were the characters. And one rule that we always have is that a character must always respond with real human emotions. So even however crazy a situation you have, when a character's responding real, people just relate to it. And they're drawn into it. And I think that's why it's just universally relatable. You can go about creating characters in different ways. You can either have sort of the setting of the show and the idea of the show first, and then you think of what characters would thrive in that, or you come from really interesting characters. But it's always just finding, a lot of times characters start as a stereotype. And then you find something interesting to build on that. For example, Homer Simpson was just like a lazy guy who didn't like to work, but then you gradually built on that and you found new dimensions and you make them real and relatable, and then suddenly they come alive. At first, to have a writing partner, you really have to be friends first. And Bill and I were best friends from high school, from third form. Well, Bill's really good at story, I'm really good at jokes. And so but we also learned from each other. So over the years, I got much better at story, Bill got better at jokes, but we just worked really well together. But I found, because I had a partner before, it's very easy to team up with other people along the way. And it's always much better to work with a partner, and you just find like you have better ideas, funnier jokes, and or when we first started out, we would literally sit at the computer screen together, one keyboard, and go line by line and come up with those lines together. But we found that was very slow and laborious. So eventually we'd sort of evolved to, we'll sit down and we'll map out a story together and figure out the general idea of a script and some jokes. Then we'd go off and we'd split the script up. And so Bill would take one act, I'd take another, and then we'd trade off. And that worked really well. And we also, we sometimes do that process on Strange Hill as well, as once a writer hands in a script, my partner Andrew Burrell here, who's script editor on Strange Hill High, will trade scripts back and forth. And we, because we trust each other and have the same sensibility, we always know each other, the other one will improve it. And so it works really well. I much prefer animation because you're much more in control of the whole world, and it's really, it all has to come from your head, and then you hand it to the animators and they'll add to it. But it's a much more, for somebody who's sort of a control freak like myself, it's more enjoyable. But it's also because you get to do so much more. And we always said with The Simpsons, and it's the same with Strange Hill High, that every episode, were it a live action movie or TV show, it would cost hundreds of millions of dollars. Whether you're sending someone to space or you're having a monster or whatever, you just couldn't do it in live action. But in animation, you can do anything. So it's really sort of like the ultimate writing experience. If you come up with a joke and you think it's been done before, or it seems familiar, don't do it. Always push yourself to do something new. And that's one reason, like, when people loved The Simpsons, is every story we did and every joke we told, we always made sure this hasn't been done before. But another secret to great comedy, I think, is just honesty, because part of comedy is pointing out the truth and tearing down walls. And you have to be really honest with yourself to do that as well. But one of the reasons it works so well is because it's comedy, because it's funny, because it's animated, it's coming out of the mouths of cartoon characters. The uneasy truth goes down much better. This is an interesting thing in the process of animation. When you make a live action show, you write the script, you film it in a night or two in front of an audience, and then it's done. And so hopefully it's funny. But in an animated show, it goes through so many forms before it airs that you're literally watching that episode 20 to 30 times before it ever goes on air. So it really has to make you laugh every single time. And if a joke makes you laugh 30 times, that's most likely a good joke.